This video is sponsored by Squarespace, an all-in-one platform to build your website and run your business. Speaking of which, this is my website, and I'm so excited to finally have it up and ready for you all. They have these simple drag-and-drop style editors. As you can see here, I picked the text box, and I'm just typing in some text as an example. And then after that, I'm going to add a gallery. This is so simple. Again, no coding or design experience at all. There's just these toggles that I'm changing the sizing with. You can add things like maps, buttons to other pages, contact forms, and all kinds of things. And when you add them to your page, they're automatically designed in a beautiful way, and you didn't have to worry about figuring that out on your own at all. So if you'd like to try Squarespace out for yourself, go ahead and go to squarespace.com/AllieCherry for your free trial and 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Let's talk about making a rental your own. I like to make our places feel like home, even when we're renting, but I don't, however, want to make wasteful updates that'll end up in the trash a year or two later when we decide to move, like removable wallpaper or just generally things that we can't take with us. So here are a few simple updates that I typically make in our rentals to make them feel cozier and more like home without the waste. In our last two rentals, I've loved the drama that a shower curtain brings to the bathroom. There's a sentence I never thought I'd say before. It's particularly helpful if your shower is ugly, but even if it's not, add a shower curtain. This rental came with a plastic shower curtain, like the liner type curtain, so I just added my decorative one to the outside on the same tension rod. The hardware doesn't match, but I don't generally like stare up at it and obsess over it, so it doesn't really bother me, which is great. As you can see, you can kind of see the liner through the bigger holes of the decorative curtain, but again, I just try not to think about it. I really like this curtain, so it works for me. This curtain was one of my favorite recent eBay finds. It was new, completely unused, and the brand hand makes them in Brooklyn, which is really cool. I love that it's cotton and easily washable, and I like how the details are sort of sail inspired. Plus, the warm green color adds a lot to this tiny space without me having to paint it and then repaint it when we leave. Update knobs. So we've had these little knobs since our first apartment together in 2013, and they're really special to me. The knobs that were on here weren't bad at all. They're actually pretty great in my rental experience, and I'm sure some of you might like them better than the cherry ones that we have, but I just really love these, and I love the color that they add. I'm not like a cherry obsessed person, but it is a fun last name, and I feel like sometimes I do have to lean into it, so that's what I'm doing here. Replace your shower head if needed. So this might be kind of weird, but I feel like it's worth mentioning. And believe it or not, this is the after shower head. It's so weird looking, but it has a filter on it. It filters out chlorine, which I appreciate. So it's just something to keep in mind. This is a really simple switch that could potentially make you a lot more comfortable in a rental. And this is something, again, that you can take with you from place to place. And so it's not getting wasted. You're holding on to the other one and you're just replacing it while you're there. I just keep all the old fixtures in a little bag labeled so that I can easily find them before we move. That goes to the sink in our kitchen, and then you can see the knobs and this little drain stopper thing. I have my own. Is that weird? I don't know. I like it better than that one. And then the shower head. So again, I just put them in a bag. They take up almost no space in our closet, and all the things that I replaced these fixtures with make me happy and make my place feel more like home. So I love that. Update lighting. This is such a huge one. So as you can see from these pictures, the lighting in our place wasn't horrible, but it was definitely not what I would go for. That one specifically made me feel like I was sitting at an interrogation table when I was eating dinner, and then some rooms, like the living room and the two bedrooms, didn't have any lights at all, so we needed to find something. My dream would have been to have a Nelson ball bubble pendant thing, but it wasn't in my budget, new or used. It was more expensive used. So I went with the next best thing, just a paper pendant. I love how this looks so much. It's so warm when it's turned on, and it just fills the room with so much beautiful diffused light. It's sort of sculptural in the same way that that bubble pendant was, but was much cheaper. I like that it has the sort of wood-toned accent to it. Isn't that so cool? That shot with the window, can you even? This light's kind of funny. It's a little bit higher than I would typically want it to be, but this was just a light from the hardware store. It was like $5 or $6, and we used it in our last place, and now we're using it here, and I feel like it is sort of mid-century feeling. We didn't have any lighting in this living room at all, so we had to find something, and we ended up going to the IKEA as-is section, which is like their section that you can get slightly damaged returned products and stuff like that, and we found this, and it was such a great find because it didn't seem to have any damage at all, and we got it half price, so I think it fills up this space really well. As you can see, we just attached it to the ceiling with a little hook. I don't know what it's called, just like a little metal hook, and then we plugged it into the wall. It's definitely a piece that I think we'll be able to keep for a long time and put in other homes that we live in, and I really love it. Speaking of having pieces for a long time, we've had this IKEA pendant for like 5 or 6 years now, and I still love it just as much as the day I bought it. It looks so pretty at nighttime, and again, this room didn't have any lighting at all, so we needed to hang something in here. I got these little sconces on OfferUp, and I really love them. They don't have to be drilled into the wall, they just take a couple of nails, and I think it's so important in rentals, or really any home really, to have lighting that isn't just overhead, because the lamps and the smaller lighting is what really makes spaces feel cozy, and I feel like that's definitely what these sconces do. Add plants and mirrors. So we use this heater in the winter, obviously, but now in the summer, probably into the fall, we won't need it, so we turned it off, and I wanted to hide it with something because it's kind of ugly. Let's be honest, it's very ugly. So I ended up finding a mirror that was tall enough to hide it completely, and it's so perfect because mirrors are great, obviously, at reflecting light and making spaces feel larger and brighter. And this mirror just happens to be right across from the biggest windows in our apartment, and I love what it does to the space, how it opens everything up and reflects the plants outside and the light. And then obviously plants, what's not to love? They clean the air, they're so beautiful, they bring life into your space. As you can see, I've gone a little pothos crazy, but if you're scared about killing houseplants or you feel like you can't keep plants alive, I'm telling you people, get yourself a pothos plant. They are so easy to keep alive. I don't have a pantry here, and I love drawers because nothing gets lost in the back of them and it's easy to keep track of things, so I made my own with a few different containers, and you can do the same thing in your kitchen. These little drawers slide in and out really easily. The bottom one's obviously heavier because I have all my cans in it, but that's why it's on the bottom and it's not a big deal at all. It makes such a huge difference for me in this tiny rental kitchen, and it's so easy to keep track of all my things. I also have a basket on top of the fridge, and I keep my Almond Cow and Instant Pot up there, and it's great because it sort of corrals that visual clutter. So those are a few things that I like to do to make my rental feel more like my home. I hope you enjoyed this video, and keep in mind, when you're out there looking for new things to bring into your home, check places like eBay, Facebook Marketplace, OfferUp, your local Buy Nothing group. There are so many amazing pieces out there that have already been created, so you can shop more sustainably and also a lot cheaper when you try secondhand first. Thanks so much for watching and for subscribing, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.